Let's see what is coming up next, shall we? Because look who is coming to get you now. It's Tyson time. 6 foot nine, 19 stone, the Manchester man getting fitter and stronger with every fight. And he's been speaking to Rob Walker.
Three from three, the man mounting continues. Tyson, feeling confident tonight? You certainly look very, very relaxed.
Yeah, I'm relaxed, feeling confident. I've got a good reason to be confident, and 3-0 with three knockouts. So tonight it's going to be 4-0 with four knockouts. So that's the best I can do, to be honest.
Lee Swaby, hold any fears for you? Obviously, everyone knows him for putting Enzo Mack down in the year 2000. That of any concern to you whatsoever?
Past history on boxers doesn't mean anything. It's how they box on the night against the opponent they've got. If you're going off other people who he's fought, then you can go on all night, but he hasn't fought Tyson Fury yet, and he doesn't pose no threat to me, as of yet anyway.
You've been up for it this week, and you've had a little bit of a tickle at David Price, maybe suggesting that he hasn't got the chin to make it as a pro. Caused a few ripples with those comments.
Yeah, to be honest, in professional boxing, as everyone knows in the heavyweight division, you cannot go in a boxing ring and not get hit. And I'm confident as soon as he gets hit on the chin, he's over. Because with how much in the amateurs, he had a big head guard and like shock-absorbent gloves, and he was going down every time he got it clear then. So now he's got the little 10-ounce gloves on, no head guard, and the people's watching him. So it's game over every time he gets on the tash.
You love this, don't you? And you've got no intention of doing it quietly.
I've got no intention of doing it quietly. I'm going to make a big wave, and I'm hoping to do that. So things going well at the moment, yeah.
Good luck tonight.
Thanks very much.
At 18 stones, he does make a very big wave. Lee Swaby is his first British opponent, 32-year-old from Lincoln, used to be a cruiserweight. He once flattened former world champ Enzo Macronelli. His last half a dozen fights have all been at heavyweight. The big men are coming right up. Just reminding you, the British middleweight title belt is on the line. Wayne Elcock, the champion, age 35, feels 10 years younger. Very accomplished champion indeed, making a mandatory defense against Matt Macklin. They're good pals, but this is business. He says it's a massive chance, and I am going to take it. First, though, another chance to chart the progress of the hottest young heavyweight prospect in the country. And we're absolutely delighted to have followed every second of Tyson Fury's professional career so far here on ITV4. And now he is all set to take on that seasoned campaigner, Lee Swaby. Your introductions come from Thomas Triber.
Ladies and gentlemen, right now at this time, let's welcome to the ring from Lincoln, Lee Swaby. Give me just one night. I'm ready to go right now. I'm ready to go right now. I'm ready to go
right. Here comes Lee Swaby, who says he will be the first man to go out there and really have a fight with Tyson Fury. He said, we don't know about Fury's chin, and I am going to be the man to test it. Taking this fight at around about a week's notice. And is he going to be strong enough and have the power to actually get to Fury?
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome to the ring from Manchester, Tyson Fury!
He's a big lad, isn't he? Just a whisker under 6 foot nine, he told me. He's not sure if he's stopped growing. Undefeated in three knockouts, 20 years old. Says he wants to fight for a British title next year. He wants the other prospects, Derek Chisora, Sam Sexton. He wants to prove that he's the best of the emerging crop of British heavies. Named, of course, after Iron Mike Tyson. That shows just what a big fella he is.
Ladies and gentlemen, the action continues with six rounds in the heavyweight division. introducing to you first, to my left in the blue corner, he's wearing black trunks and weighed in at 16 stone, 5 pounds, 9 ounces. Hailing from Lincoln, his record consists of 23 wins, 22 defeats, 2 draws, with 11 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Lee Swaby. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent fighting tonight in the red corner, he's wearing green trunks with white trim and weighed in at 17 stone, 12 pounds, 6 ounces. Coming to us from Manchester, he was the 2008 Senior Super Heavyweight Champion, and now as a professional, he is undefeated with 3 wins, and all 3 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Tyson Fury.
Good reception for
our
the
referee in charge is John Keane. 6 round scheduled.
There's a growing buzz around the game. How good is he going to be?
Obey all my instructions promptly. And when I tell you to break, you stop punching and clearly step back. Is that understood? And nothing on the back of the neck. Shake hands, come out boxing.
Lee Swaby, trained by Richard Poxon. Got Dennis Hobson in there in the corner with him as well, the promoter. And there's the enormous figure of Tyson Fury, who's barred some 30 rounds in the run-up to this with Ola Ofolabi, who's fighting Enzo Macronelli this evening. What's he going to produce tonight? Or is Swaby going to have the power and the determination to get in there as he threatens and test his chin?
Well, Swaby's been around for a long time, won't be overawed.
As Jim and Barry were saying, once beat Enzo Macronelli. Borson lost against Mark Hobson, John Keaton in British title fights as a cruiser. Should have beaten by Derek Chisora in his last outing. Fury weighing in underneath 18 stone. He's really just been ticking over. He's fighting, keeping really busy, which is good to see. And that's good hand speed. And that's a nice variety of work, Fury.
It is good hand speed by Fury. Pull back through the right hand, pull back with a sweeping left hook.
Good body shot, Duke. Lovely.
Stop boxing! Box on!
Lee Swaby, a popular figure around Lincoln Way. Now allowing Fury to dictate with that jab. Left hand, of course, is his danger punch, Swaby.
It's easy for Fury to keep it at range, obviously being the taller of the two, the longer reach of the two. Swaby has to try and make himself a smaller target, try and get into him a little bit closer.
Certainly lacks nothing in confidence, does Tyson Fury. He said to me in all seriousness, you want me to fight Skelton, you want me to fight Rogan? Yeah, okay, I don't have to rush for it, but I'll take them. Good body shots. Swaby feeling the power of those.
Fury doesn't have to put himself in the punching range, in the firing line. He just doesn't have to do it. It's equally amount of power at distance.
That's where both Klitschko brothers have been so successful over the years. And his uncle and trainer, Huey, pretty pleased with the way it's going.
think it's also good that Fury's getting, you know, boxers of different shapes, different sizes. Swaby's not as stocky or as out of condition as some of Fury's previous opponents.
And a southpaw.
And a southpaw to boot. So, you know, it poses him a different kind of a problem, the right-handed stance.
He's still trying his luck with that left hand, catching Fury off balance there. Glancing blow on the shoulder.
Swaby's been there, seen it and done it. Not overawed at all. Hooked onto a big shot there and he's stopped in his tracks with a right hand.
That's a lovely combination from Fury. To Swaby from his corner, don't wait for him. It's easier said than done when your opponent is some 6 or 7 inches taller than you are.
Hold it, Tyson, let him go!
But Swaby headhunting, I'm not quite sure why. I'm not going to hit the head all day long.
Well, I suppose he threatened that he was going to test his chin out, didn't he? And he spent most of the fight looking for it. Rather large target with the beard on it.
That was a good body shot there by Fury.
Swaby settles back into the corner again. Shows he's got a bit of fight left in him, the way he turned his man there. Fury, I'm sure, would love to say he'd stop Swaby here in the second round to do one better than Derek Chisora. Big rival on the heavyweight scene, the young London heavyweight who's emerging from the Frank Warren stable. That left hand from Swaby did get through. And now Swaby, for the first time, having his own measure of success. But back comes Fury. Good, solid shots, Duke.
Well, Fury's had to respond. He's been clipped for the first time. Didn't like it.
That's a good jab. Good lead from Swaby. Oh, the Lincoln man's had his moments. Lee Swaby telling his corner that he's finding it difficult to relax, difficult to get into the fight. Well, he needs to start relaxing pretty soon. Tyson Fury now certainly winning the opening round and probably taking the second as well, Duke, yep.
Yes, two rounds to Fury. You know, Swaby not doing too bad. You know, he's still looking game enough. He's still on his feet. Still trying to find a way to win this fight.
Swaby's making a fight of it, though. He did get through with a few good shots. Right-hand lead, the southpaw jab, giving Tyson Fury a few problems. Fury, I suspect, probably learned more in the 30 or so rounds that he sparred with Ola Afolabi than he has done in his first three paid contests so far. Swaby taking the punch as well.
Yeah, Swaby not doing a bad job of tucking up, but Fury's got quite good hand speed. You know, puts 2, 3, 4 punch combinations together in succession. Learning fight thus far for Fury.
Yeah, he's learning more from this as he has some of his opponents prior to this.
Step in.
A couple of who could politely be described as a little bit on the roly-poly side in his last two fights. And Swaby, as a few can attest to over the years, can certainly handle himself. He knows his way around a boxing ring. Hand from Fury. Swaby marking up a little bit around the right eye.
Wing it,
too much coming back from Swaby at this stage.
Tyson Fury just working him over in this round, doing pretty much exactly what he wants to do. Been a much more dominant round for me by Fury.
Swaby all the time looking for that left hand, but it's thrown with more of an air of desperation than it was earlier on.
Swaby's got to punch back because the referee won't hesitate to stop this one.
John Keane having a good look at him. It's all Fury at this stage. Big round for Tyson Fury. And not too much back from Swaby now. That's a big right hand. Swaby wants to hold on and buy a few seconds.
Yeah, and for the first time, you saw Swaby deliberately grab Fury.
Oh, that's a big round for Tyson Fury. His trainer, Huey Fury, looks across to see what sort of damage has been done in the other corner to Lee Swaby, and he knows that it's going in the direction of the big man once more.
Soften him right. Listen to me. Yeah. Keep at him. Don't let him stand and rest. If you let him rest, he's pulling his wind again. Hard shots. Turn
letting his punches right. Flow, wasn't he, in that third round, Duke?
It was quite impressive by Fury for me. Little clusters on the inside there, both hands. Watch this right hand. I mean, that is a...
That's quality,
that's,
isn't it?
That's very good. It's very good.
Last 30 seconds, as dead as a chip, give it to
you. OK? Corners,
catch
him!
Shield! Come shield! Yeah,
follow him. Hands up! Round four!
Moving into the fourth round. Tyson Fury has yet to be taken the distance in a contest. It's a sixth round of this.
Well, you know, there's a first time for everything. Might happen tonight.
Lee Swaby still trying to step inside, trying to nail his man with that left hand.
I do think there's a marked improvement with Fury. He has to exercise patience against this kind of an opponent. Can't take him out with one shot. So we systematically try to break him down.
Swaby's a much better fighter than the likes of Daniel Perrott, who Fury fought in his last contest.
See, Swaby was hurt with a body shot there in that last little counterpunch that he threw. He was hurt with a body shot, but managed to disguise it. So Fury hasn't seen that.
Plenty of the old pro about Lee Swaby. You can see from the way his mouth's hanging open now, he's really feeling this, trying to counter off the ropes. He did get through with one, but here comes another sustained attack from Fury, and the referee again is looking closely at Lee Swaby.
Swaby just, you know, tucking his right arm, his left arm underneath Fury's right arm and just pulling him in tight. Just buying a little bit of time. All right, he's hurt, he's tired. He's just doing enough to buy himself a little bit of time.
Trying to unload with these shots now, Fury. You can hear him grunting with effort as he unloads.
Desperate for the knockout. Yeah, he's desperate for the knockout, Fury.
Doesn't want to get careless, though. Swaby's still in there. Those body shots are hurtful shots, but Swaby taking them well, showing commendable bravery.
They just turned Fury on the ropes there quite comfortably.
He's hurt. He's trying to sucker him in, isn't he?
Yeah.
Still just trying to find that one big punch to really test Fury, who incidentally claims, and I've no reason to disbelieve him, and I certainly wouldn't make an argument with him anyway, but he says he's never been on the floor in any sort of fight, either in the gym or anywhere else, and never even taken a standing eight count.
Well, I tell you what, these are good punches from Fury, because he's given himself a little bit of an angle on the inside to punch freely with both hands.
Lee Swaby will be able to tell us just what he makes of this. Well, hopefully he will.
But I tell you what, that right uppercut that Fury just threw there was enough to take your head clean off your shoulders. But Swaby's still on his feet. That's commendable.
People out there who say that Fury doesn't punch as hard as some. He's throwing a lot of them. Can you try telling this fella? He knows he can punch a bit. I think they're going to pull him out. I think it may be finishing here. They're having a look at him. Yep, the fight's over. Lee Swaby's had enough. And Tyson Fury has won the fight. Merciful decision by Dennis Hobson and Richard Box, and they knew that their man was just about all in after that fourth round. And Tyson Fury, with Swaby retiring on his stool, makes it four wins out of four. He took a heck of a lot of shots. Showed some real guts, Lee Swaby, in there tonight. But in the end, he was just taking an avalanche of punches.
He certainly was, but no disgrace. I tell you, you know, he's shown us more in those rounds than obviously what Fury's had previously, because he wasn't up against much. But what I like about Fury in this particular fight was his patience. Never went crazy, never went right hand happy, was content just to box behind the jab, put little clusters together, you know, trying different things all of the time. Quite impressive.
He learnt something there, unquestionably. Came through a little test against a tough southpaw in Lee Swaby, who battled hard, clipped him once or twice, didn't he? And gave him more of a fight than those who've gone before. But the learning curve moves on for Tyson Fury. He's moving onwards and upwards, and he says, whoever you want to put in front of me, so far as Britain's concerned, I will take them. Tyson Fury looks pretty happy with the way things have gone so far, doesn't he? Lee Swaby telling him what he thought of him, right in there. He looks bright and happy. Master of Ceremonies, incidentally, if you're wondering where confirmation of the results gone, he's got a little bit of a problem with his microphone here. But the fight finishing after four rounds, Lee Swaby being retired by his corner and Tyson Fury emerging victorious. So there's your winner, Tyson Fury, and we'll come back with more from him, no doubt, before too long.
Absolutely, John, a good learning fight, that one for Tyson Fury. Don't forget, coming up, the British middleweight title fight made in heaven between Wayne Elcock and Matt Macklin. Tyson Fury has really done the business in great style here against Lee Swaby, the toughest one, I would think, the toughest professional fight of his career so far. But Tyson coming through four hard rounds, and the brave, brave man from Lincoln retired on his stool. A right decision as well. Tyson, I would think you learnt more in that fight than your other professional fights put together.
Yeah, I knew he was like an awkward type of customer, and he was really awkward than I thought when I got in there with him. And the plan was to soften him up a bit over a few rounds, and then like fourth and fifth and sixth, I was going to like try and get him out of there.
Sure.
But
he didn't. He shows you can take a shot as well.
I can take a shot. I can take a shot. I never got hurt or wobbled or anything, but I knew that anyway. And I've been sparring like top-class, world-class people. I'm not getting rocked or nothing, so the chin's solid.
And an awkward opponent for you to take at this stage of your career.
Oh, it was awkward. Yeah, it was awkward than I thought. I always struggle with southpaws, though. I always do struggle with them. But practice makes perfect, doesn't it?
Absolutely. And one thing that I've noticed about you, I mean, when you first weighed in and made your professional debut, yeah, you were carrying a bit of timber around the middle, weren't you? But you're getting fitter and fitter.
Yeah, I'm getting fitter and fitter. Well, I could have done the distance there really easy. And my weight's, it's like I'm tuning it in to get in better shape, but it comes gradually. But long way to go, so big things in the future.
Well, let's have a quick word with Mick Hennessy. Just a very quick one, Mick. In the future, what's next for Tyson?
Well, he's going to be boxing on the Cole Frotch, Jermaine Taylor bill in Connecticut at the Foxwoods on April 25th. That's his next outing. So, you know, he's had four fights in 3 months now.
Absolutely.
And he's had some tough opposition for someone, you know, especially his age and inexperience. And I know Lee Swaby thought he was going to take him out tonight because of his inexperience.
Sure.
So that was a brilliant job he just done.
Decent start for the little fella.
Yeah, fantastic.
Well done, both. Well done.